He's getting scared.
Am I dancing?
Woohoo! How are we, everyone? Happy Friday. Time to put your feet up on Friday and think about what property investing can do for you. I'm here with Tony Meredith.
Hi, Luke.
And we're at the French Twist Cafe, a little unique dining spot here in Bulimba in Brisbane. Just thought we'd come out and about and talk a little bit about property, a little bit about mindset. We're here in the middle of the road.
We're in the middle of the road.
So it's all about a combination of different things. Natalia, good to have you on. David, thanks for joining. Tony, let's get straight into it.
Yes.
We've been talking a little bit of property and development so far already. I believe when it comes to property investing, property development, that 20% of it's kind of like your knowledge, skills, and experience. 80% of it comes into mindset. That can be, you know, divided up in different things.
Yeah.
You've got a little bit of a different twist on things, like the French twist behind me.
That's it.
What is your twist on thinking about mindset and...
Sure. So my twist is that 10% comes from knowledge, right? 15% comes from skills. So just because you have the knowledge doesn't necessarily mean that you've got the skills. And it's the old Chinese proverb of to know and not to do is to not know at all. So just because you know something, you choose not to do it, well, you may not as well know in the first place. So it's 10% for knowledge, 15% for skills. You need to have the skills to pull this stuff off. And then it's about 75% that sits in between your ears. The 75% being, how do you overcome limiting beliefs? How do you keep pushing through when you get all those inevitable challenges? So how do you work through your fears, creating certainty when there isn't certainty, etc.?
So Tony, where do you get all these Chinese proverbs from? Have you got a background or...
So we're here at the French Twist, so you want me to talk about the Chinese side of things as well, do you?
No, that's okay.
No, look, just through research, just through a whole lot of studies over many, many years.
It's good to get a sense of different education, different research from various different backgrounds. So I know that, you know, I've been to Tony Robbins events. Yeah. We talk a lot about Gary Vee.
Yeah, correct.
It's good to get insights from, you know, people from the distant past. You know, people that are currently in working with things right now.
Of course, and you don't want to be one-dimensional, right? So you want to try and take as much information from as many different sources as you can and then formulate your own ideas, formulate your own opinions. And so whether it be a Chinese proverb, whether it be the guys that you mentioned, Tony and Gary Vee, I also listened to a neuroscientist, Dr. Joe Dispenza, a fascinating guy. So there's a whole range of different sources that I get my information from. Also a big believer in education. Like yesterday I was at a business seminar.
Wow.
You know, I run, along with Rob Flux, property seminar, and I'm a business coach as well. So looking at different sources to create who I am today, and also just life experiences. So whether it be through jobs, through managers, through people you've worked with, through associations like you, Ty.
Where do you think you get your best information about development of yourself, where you can actually help so many other people? We're talking about mindset, guys, and we really want to reflect on that because it's a big part of property investing, property development. You know, we've talked about that whole thing as people jump into the idea of property development because of that big, quick cash. But Tony, where do you get those thoughts and process that best?
Sure.
So, is it through the research or is it through other sources?
Sure. So initially it's through research. If I just share, I'm not sure how much time we've got, but I'll share a little
bit
of mine.
You've got all day.
Oh, fantastic. Well, let me kick back. So let me tell you about my story.
It is Feed Up Friday.
So for me, back in the start of 2015, life was pretty dark for me. And so the thing that I did is I read a book, Stephen Covey's 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. And in there he talks about a chapter around begin with the end in mind. And he talks about your eulogy and what people will say about you when you pass on. That was quite confronting when I first read it, but then it got me thinking that at that point in time in my life, my eulogy wasn't reading that well. And so the first thing that I did is I accepted responsibility for the fact that where my life was at the age of 42, was because of me. And that's what came out of that particular book. Then I went off and did a whole lot of activities on myself. I did a weight loss challenge. I got involved in property development. I've also gone and studied NLP, neuro-linguistic programming.
A practitioner now?
Yeah, okay. Practitioner in neuro-linguistic programming. And then also through just different life experiences as well, whether it be work experiences, etc. But the key is, again, there's the knowledge and the theory side, but you've got to put it into practice. So to be successful in property development, and I'll come back to that because I know this is a Facebook program, Your Business is Property. You've got to get into buy property. You know, so I say to people in property development, at some stage you have to pull the trigger. You're not going to know what it feels like, right? You're not going to know the emotions, the fear, etc., unless you pull that trigger. And that's how you do the true learning.
So Gary Vee talks a lot about, he learns from others' comments and others' interactions about consumer behavior and what's out there. Do you feel that you're a case of learning from seeing what others are doing, or is it a case of doing your own research and reading books and seeing what other people are...
No, it's a combination, because as a business coach, I've put my business coach hat on, I get to deal with a whole range of people, and I get to experience some of the challenges that they're going through with a view of then helping them through that. And so it's about me recognising some of the common problems that I'm seeing and making sure that, you know, I've got plenty of challenges myself, and making sure that I'm constantly working on myself. The key for this is about creating a routine. Create a routine that you work on yourself every day. So if people want to do fitness, they will go to the gym regularly, right? But why don't we spend time working on our mind, you know? And so it's important that you work on yourself on a regular basis. I have a morning routine, I go through it, I go through affirmations and visualizations, I create the beliefs. And I touched on the word uncertainty before. The only way that you can create certainty is by believing that something's going to happen before it happens. Mm. So I was able to leave my job in March of 2018, and I believed it was going to happen 2 years before it happened. And I visualized that event happening every single day, and it happened.
I've done this on a couple of occasions. It was the same for me with leaving work. It was the same in regards to putting out there on... I wanted to buy 15 investment properties within a 2-year period. I was able to complete it in 18 months rather than 2 years by just putting it up on the wall. I didn't look at it that much, but you know, maybe if I looked at it even closer, I would have been able to complete it in 12 months, not 18 months, right?
So potentially,
you know, it's that thought process, that mindset training, like Tony says, is where it can take you from here up to there. In terms of like working on that mindset, is that what you're saying?
That's what I'm saying. It's about taking yourself to the next level, and you can achieve anything that you want in your life. So whether it be in property investment, you want to go and get 15 properties, or whether you want to get into property development, or whether you want to start a side hustle, or whether you want to just develop your career, it doesn't really matter. You can achieve anything, but you need to see it in your mind first. You know, so you think about everything in this world has started as a thought. So this camera that we're talking into, this phone, started as a thought. Someone, probably Steve Jobs, thought about that particular phone. If you've got a pen, someone thought about a pen, they thought about it in their mind, they drew it down, they handed it over to manufacturing, they created the pen, and they sold it. Every single thing around you started as a thought, so why can't you do that with your life? Why can't you create what your future life looks like? So what tends to happen is most people will tend to get up in the morning and they'll look back at something that's certain, and that is their past. And what I'm saying is the way that you create certainty in your future is by working out what is your future going to look like. Actually,
and ideas are easy, right? Mm. It's actually the implementation of that. You know, everyone's got ideas. It's like with Uber. You know, there's plenty of people have said that they had the idea about Uber, but no one, it was only those couple of guys that actually put it into place.
They put it all on the line. And I said before about to know and not to do is to not know, and not to bring up the Chinese proverb again. but I thought I'd throw it in once more, and the crowd's loving it. But it's all about the world actually doesn't need any more ideas, right? There's so many ideas in the world. It's all about the execution on those ideas. If you're in a job that you're not feeling fulfilled with, and you want to be able to leave your job, and you've got something you want to work towards, then get out and work towards it. It's not going to be easy, right? It's not going to be easy, but here's the thing. It's actually designed to be difficult, and I believe it's designed to be difficult because that's the universe's culling process. It's about those people who think, hey, this is going to be easy. I want to get into property development. I want to go and make $100,000 in 9 months. but it's a lot more difficult than that. But people tend to get caught up in the glory, as same as with our sports stars. We see all these people on television, footy players, netball players, whatever, and we have all this adulation towards them, but it's all about, there's a lot of hard work that goes on behind the scenes.
Yeah, people don't know what LeBron goes through, right?
And
Gary talks about that a lot. Like, you know, no one sees him in the training, in the training rooms, in the gym, and on a constant basis. Let's just touch on this idea about this thought we've been discussing off camera about an absolute guarantee. So putting it out to everyone out there who's watching right now, Tony's come up with this thought. If you had an investment opportunity that was 100% absolute guarantee, 100%.
Was not going to fail.
Would you actually go ahead and make that investment?
Absolutely. I would love to get people's thoughts on it, because I believe that a lot of reason that people hold themselves back is because they're uncertain about their future. They start off full of gusto. Whenever you start something new, whether it be a weight program, whether it be getting into property, whatever, you start off in that first 2 to 4 weeks and you're full of gusto, and it's that motivation that keeps you going. But then you start to hit a few bumps, a few obstacles, a few challenges, and you start to get a bit wobbly. And then your mind starts to digress to, well, maybe this isn't going to work. And then what happens is, where your thoughts go, your energy flows. And so what I mean by that is, you start to think about, hey, this mightn't work. That then starts to manifest and get bigger and bigger and bigger.
All those negatives come up.
And before you know it, guess what happens? It doesn't work. And so I've got an idea, which is, if something was 100% guaranteed. Now, we can't guarantee. I mean, there's only two guarantees, that is death and taxes. Other than that, if something was guaranteed, if you had a game, just ask yourself the question, if it was guaranteed, would you invest it? If I guaranteed you, if you gave me 50 grand and I 100% guarantee you that I'll give you back 60 grand in 6 months' time, would you do it? I'd love people to come on board and let me know their thoughts. It's interesting, we asked Ty just before, you know, and it's interesting just going through the...
Shout out to Ty
Bate, who's got the camera in the background, but it's interesting with all the paradigms that people go through. Like,
he's still thinking about it.
Yeah.
Still blocked there somewhere about investing, about that thought about guarantees. And it's just really interesting for us to talk about this, about mindset, about the, you know, the 80% mindset, the 20% knowledge and skill, and Tony breaks it up a little bit different. But that whole thing about uncertainty just holds so many people back, and even putting that 100% guarantee to someone, they're still having
doubts,
blockages.
They're still having blockages. Where it all starts, so where it all starts is, it starts with your beliefs. So you need to believe that you can make this happen. You need to have this unwavering sense of belief that come hell or high water, no matter what the obstacles, no matter what the challenges, that you believe that you can do it. Doesn't mean that you have all the answers, but you have a resourceful mind that's going to enable you to seek out the answers. So instead of saying, well, this can't work, why don't you flip that question around to say, how can I make it work? Who do I need to speak to? Who's the expert? Speak to a property investment expert? What do I need to do? What research, etc., to find the answer?
Can't stop talking.
How long have I got?
All day, Tony, all day. We're going to do a whole blog one day, and we'll just go 24 hours like maybe Gary Vee did. What did he go, 36 hours of video or something like that?
Let's do 37. If Gary Vee's doing 36, we'll do 37.
Right? Absolutely.
Let's get serious.
I want to leave one last question.
Yeah.
Are we thinking about that whole sense of we've got one life enough?
No.
Are we thinking about this enough as individuals?
No, we're not. No, a lot of people walk around thinking like they're going to live till they're 1,000. You know, and it's not going to happen. I'm sorry to break that to you here first, but it's not going to happen. And so the reality, but the reality is that, you know, the average lifespan is somewhere between 80 and 90. And okay, there's advents of modern medicine, etc. But, you know, I'm 46, so I'm at the sort of halfway stage, you know, tipping over into the second half of my life. And for me, you know, one of the sayings that I have is, it's never too late to start. So wherever you are in your life, if you aren't happy, if you're in your 40s, your 30s, whatever, if you're not happy, what are you going to do about it? You know, because if you're 30, you've got another 50, 60, 70 years to go. Are you going to live those years being unhappy? So no, I don't believe that people are focused on that enough. I think we get up and we take it for granted. We live in Australia. It's a lucky country. The word that I use a lot is comfort. I believe that people are comfortable. right? So they're comfortable.
We haven't had a recession in 28 years.
No, that's right. And depends
that's
on
comfort.
Depends on who you listen to. But I believe that it's comfort. I think that people say, well, look, my life's okay. My job's okay. Everything's, I'm comfortable. And so there's another saying, if you don't mind, which is change happens when the pain of staying the same becomes greater than the change itself. So whenever you go and change, it's going to be hard, right? It's going to be difficult. Whatever it is that you're going to do, it doesn't have to be into property. It could be into developing your career or doing a weight loss challenge, whatever it is. It's going to be difficult. But you think about where you are in your life, and if you're comfortable in your life, if it's more difficult to actually do the change, then you're not going to change. But when you start to create the fact that where you are at the moment, you need to change, you must change, you are fed up with your life as it is, you are no longer comfortable, in fact, you're incredibly uncomfortable, then that's when you're going to start to change. And a lot of people talk about you need to hit rock bottom before people change. I hear it all the time. I think that's a whole lot of rubbish.
Yeah, but it's often the truth.
I get it.
It's often, actually, I've seen it so many times, people need to hit rock bottom before they actually take action. We just want to avoid that.
Right? And that's the point, and that's why I say it's a whole lot of rubbish. So yes, I see it, I agree that it happens. But you don't want to hit rock bottom for you to have to make a
change.
You don't want to have to have a heart attack to then decide that you want to go and get yourself fit and healthy. You don't
Absolutely.
Want to go and have only, no money to decide, well, hang on, I now better get moving. And so what you do is you start to change the thought that you've got for yourself, and you start to project forward and change the meaning. So what I mean by that is you start to think about that in the future, in 6 months, in 12 months, if I haven't changed, if my life is still where it is today, how am I going to feel? And if that's not working
like
for you, maybe. And if you feel like a loser, then bang, get up off the couch and get into it, whatever it is you're going to do. If 12 months isn't working for you, shoot it out to 24 months. So project that meaning out to 24 months or in 36 months. If in 3 years' time you haven't changed, you haven't done the hard work, you haven't done the things that you know you need to be doing, how are you going to feel? And so for me, if I go back to my story, for those who've listened this whole interview, it was all about thinking about my eulogy at the end of my life was a catalyst for me to go, that is a crap eulogy, and I need to do something about it. So I'm not suggesting you need to think about the end of your life. Perhaps it's in 12 months, in 24 months. If you're in a job that you don't like today, think about the fact that in 2 years' time, if you're still in that job, how are you going to feel? And you want to start to build up those emotions within you to a point where it's like, bang, I now need to do something about it.
It just makes me think, how do you as an individual have a remarkable life? And maybe it's a good way to end this today, because our breakfast is getting cold, and yep. And Tony's been on a rant for a good 25 yep. minutes or so now. And hopefully you've enjoyed that whole process. I have. I always learn something of Tony. I think we bounce off a lot of ideas about mindset with each other.
Yeah, correct.
I look forward to speaking to anyone in terms of property investing mindset. Tony as well. Hit up Tony. He's been tagged into this post. Yep. If you want to have a chat with him, a lot of gold information that you can gain from him, and a lot of accountability along the way. So hopefully that helps you with your mindset, with your property investing. Because a big part of your property investing, your property development, is around what's going on up here.
Absolutely. So I just want to finish.
Final word.
But I just want to finish by saying, you can achieve anything that you want in your life. You truly, truly can. Right. I was 42 down and out, and now I don't need to work for anyone. I get to live the life on my terms. You can achieve anything you want, but you have to work out what that is first, and you have to then understand, why do you want to do that? And if you can do those things, and then just tirelessly, consistently and persistently put in the effort day after day after day, with the belief that I know that if I keep going, I'm going to achieve what I want, the hustle, then you can achieve anything that you want in your life, whether it be property investing, property development, side hustle, whatever. I should stop, mate, to be honest. I could keep going.
I could keep on as well. I'm just concerned about my breakfast as well, because I'm looking forward to enjoying the bit of the French twist action that's going on behind
us. Cold French twist.
The cold French twist. Yeah. But over and out for today, guys. Have a great Friday. Put your feet up. Think about what property investing could do for you, and work on your mindset.
Thank you.